Hello dear children, we are going to study about the further part of population. Population, further part is distribution of population. Here you could see in this map, the population is been distributed. Some of the region you will find the population is dense, that means more crowd is there, and in some of the region you will find less crowd. That means the more number of people in some region and less number of people in some other region. Then think why this is happening. No, some of the population is distributed more, that means number of people are more towards the river, number of people are more towards the plain surface of the land. You will not find more people on the top of the mountain building a house and staying on top of the mountain. You will not find the people in the forest, okay, because there are wild animals and it is very dangerous to build the house in the forest. Okay, either you will not find the people living in the snowfall, very high snowfall region. So if there is a favorable condition, then the population in that region goes on increasing, okay, and the number of people goes on increasing. We say that region is densely populated, it is dense. Okay, so let's see what are the factors which affects the distribution of population. How the people are being distributed, how the population is distributed. People like to live where there is more facilities provided to the citizens or to provided to the people. Okay, so here there is an activity in your textbook. What is there? Left side region, that is the area which is been marked. Okay, one area is bigger and the another area right side you will find the area is small. Okay, left side area is big and right side area marked is small region, small area. Here what happens, you have taken some pulses, they have asked you to take chowli, that is you have taken some pulses, same amount of pulses. Okay, so these are being spread in the large area and same amount of pulses are spread in small area. Okay, or either you take only some quantity of pulses and spread in that large area, you will find they are spread rarely. That is either density what you are spreading, it is spread wide. Okay, there is a space in between that area, you take them, represent it as the people. Okay, think they are the people. Same quantity now collected this chowli and spread it in the small area, you will find the area which is being small but the amount of the chowli, that is pulses, are same. Now what is the difference in between these two figures? Okay, what are the difference? Here where area is more, population is less dense. Okay, the number of people are less, so they are spread, and where area is small, number of people are same according to that, but here we could see that the population is dense of that people. So densely populated region and here rarely populated, that is low dense or here high dense. Okay, so here there is more crowd, your right hand side figure is more crowd, having more crowd of people, and here less crowd. Even though the area is more but people don't want to live in that, and here even though area is less, people go and make crowd there. Now think why it is so, why people go and make crowd, or either the population becomes more dense in the region where there is no place also to live. What must be the reason? So let's find out some reason, what are some of the factors are there which affects the distribution of population. So let's see these factors. So some factors are here, physical factors like location, relief, climate, soil, mineral resources. Location, where the location is suitable for the people to live. Okay, there is a proper transport, there is proper facility of markets. No, the location is close to the railways, or either it is close to the river, or the soil is good, the climatic condition is suitable for living. There is a good mineral resources, all these are called as physical factors. Or else if you are suffering from diseases, or either there is some calamities, there will be the quick relief from these calamities for for these people, okay? That means you will get a relief soon. That means if disasters are there in that region, people will run, no? Those helpers will run towards you easily, fast, in that region. So that type of places are suitable for living. The next is the economic factors. Economic factors means the factor which can, by which you can earn money and live. Nowadays you require money for living, isn't it? To satisfy all your basic needs. So if agriculture is done proper there in that region, industries are there, urbanization, that means if cities are more, facilities provided to the people are good, if transport system is good, there are good roads, railways, okay, airports, then people like to live in these type of places. If market facility is good, okay, so people like to stay in this type of region. So you will find population is more over this region. If these facilities are not there, if these factors are not proper, then you will find in that region population is less dense. Political factors like wars, political instability, government policies, if all these factors are not good, if wars are there, if political factors like political instability is there, every time the leader has to be changed, the leaders are not good, or either there are no government policies followed, then you will find the population also gets disturbed. Social factor is the race, religion, language, customs and tradition, what race is followed. So all these factors affects the population distribution. Okay, so these are the factors which affects the population distribution. The religion, language, you must be knowing all this. So negative factors, sparse population, where negative factors in this type of region, people will not like to live. So what are these type of region? That is desert. You'll find there is no population in the desert. You'll find there is no population in the dense forest. Nobody will like to live, build a house in the dense forest, because wild animals will trouble you. They will not allow you to live there, or either it will be too dangerous. If there is no proper rain, no river, so people will not like to go and stay in that region, and population will be very, very less. Okay, whether they are living, but they are living with a great difficulty. Steep slopes are there, very steep slopes. Mountains are very high and they are very slopy. In this slopy mountain, nobody will like to build the house, or either the mountains are covered with snow. Okay, for a few days you will like to live in the snow, but not for the whole life. Okay, if there are no job facilities also, then there will be less population. There will be no jobs if there are unemployment spread there. People don't have any job, no industries, no factories, no offices. People will not like to stay in that type of region. No industries, few. If there are no industries, raw materials are not provided properly, and the soil condition is also not good for agriculture. So these type of regions are not suitable for the people. So people, you will find in this type of region, population is very, very less dense or sparse. Where population is more or densely populated region, okay, region mostly populated where jobs facilities are good. Populated region where rivers are there, near the river you will find population is more because of good water supply. Gentle slopy hills, if hills are there, if population is close to the hill and hills are not so steep, they are gentle, not so slopy, so there you will find the people can build the house, agriculture practice also can be done. Good soil also is favorable for densely population, because farmers require this good soil for agriculture. If pleasant climate is there, good food supply, grassland is there, open grassland is there for the cattle, for the animals, raw materials are provided, good communication centers, communication, good roads, railways, as well as ports are there close to that region, close to this type of region, you will find population is dense, or either more number of people like to go and live in that region. So the density of population is being calculated according to the formula, or you can use the formula. See, the density of population, the ratio of population of a country to its area, so the amount of area and people living in that area. So you require to calculate, measure the area as well as the number of people living in that area. So how is the formula used? The density of population is equal to population of a region and area of the region. Okay, the number of people in that region and the area of that region will give you the density. How much dense the population is? Dense means either it is crowded or either not. So you have to, there is a table in your textbook on page number 44. You have to complete this table. You can use the calculator because the numbers are very, very big. Okay, the numbers are in crores. So you can find out the density of these given 6 regions are there: Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, and you can compare which region is more dense or which region is less dense. They have given the population, number of people, and they have given the area in square kilometer. Okay, you can find and complete this chart and show me. You have to click the photo and send me after completing this work. You have to apply this formula for finding out the density of population in that given region. 6 areas are given of India. So the structure of population again is been grouped. Okay, the structure of population is, now there are different varieties of people living in that population. Population means not only 35 age people, not only 45 age people. Population is all together. There are small children, there are newborns also in the population. There are one year children also. There are old people above 60 years, above 70 years. There are young people, there are working people, there are students. So all these together are in that population, in that region. So we make the groups of this population. Now why we require to make the group? What this group means? Groups in the population, it means the male, how many number of male, how many number of female, how many number of aged people, how many number of adolescent people, how many number of unemployed people, how many number of dependent people. Dependent people means the people who are aged and they don't have job now, or either they are retired and now they are dependent on the employed ones, dependent on their children or dependent on their young ones. So these are the groups made for the structure of population. How the structure of the population is, in China now old age people are more and young age people are less. In our India, young age people are more and old age people are less. You will find in India there are your youth which are there, the studying youth are more in number. Okay, so we say that our India is very strong country because we have large number of youth and we are now completely dependent on these youth for bringing our India the leader of the world, because we have more power in what how we have more power because we have young generation. Okay, this young generation is a backbone of that country. Okay, so that requires, when in your house many times people or either the government people must be visiting for survey, and they keep get the note, they have a form, and in that form they write they ask you that how many number of people living in the house, how many are working, how many are students, which class they study, okay, how many are old people. All this survey is been made and this survey is assembled, okay, assembled, and then together it is been sent and then government gets the survey, gets the number of all these people of the country. Okay, so here are the structure of population. This structure is decided by the groups. Now these groups are all whatever just now I have told, that is male, adolescents. Adolescent means the young age, young male, that is after the age of 30, then 30 to 40. Okay, then illiterate, how many are illiterate children, or either the newborns, or either the school going students, or the college going students, how many are literate, how many are old, all these are called as groups. Next is the sex ratio. Sex ratio means the number of male and the female. As per the gender, the population is divided into males and females. So this is a natural division. Okay, the number of males and the number of female. If number of male and female are equal, then we say that the population is balanced. Good. Okay, if the number of male and female are, it varies, number of males are more and number of females are less, so it will be very very difficult to get a partner for marriage purpose also, as well as there will be a lot of inequality, no, gender inequality we say. So why this gender inequality requires here, the number of males and female are either more or less. So how to find the number of male and female in that region? So there is again a formula here. Sex ratio is equal to total number of females upon total number of male multiplied by 1000. So in India, the sex ratio in India is 945 females per 1000 males. So naturally here the number of females are less than the number of males. If you think of marriage, or if you think of getting the couple, you'll find how many of the males will remain without marriage. Okay, so here the number is, it varies. So if the number varies, what happens if females are more and males are less, or males are more and females are less? So we say whether the population is high, the sex ratio is high, or sex ratio is low. How to know sex ratio is high and sex ratio is more? So here you see, in 2007 you will find number of male and female was same. In 2019 males increased and female number decreased. And in 2031 you see what happened. Only one lady for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that means it is, number of females are decreasing and number of males are increasing. Okay, so this is called as the sex ratio. Sex means the females and the male. Okay, so when for every 1000 males the number of females is less, the sex ratio is said to be low. If the number of females are less, then the sex ratio is said to be low. And if the number of females are more, the sex ratio is said to be high. So here there is a chart in your textbook. No, there is a graph in your textbook on page number 45. You could see this graph. Okay. And according, read the graph and answer these questions. The bar will tell you, this bar will tell you the year, the number of males they will tell, and the bar, that is the whole bar, is going to tell you the number of females. So your Haryana one I'll read and show you. Haryana having 900 males and 879 females. Other than that, in Kerala the number of females are 1084. Okay, so this is the number which are varying of that male and the female. Okay, so just try to answer these questions and please send me, solve these. Okay, that is on page number पेज नंबर 44 यू हैव टू सॉल्व द डेंसिटी ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन. आई हैव टोल्ड यू यू कैन यूज द कैलकुलेटर बिकॉज द नंबर्स आर टू बिग हियर. ओके सो यू कैन यूज द कैलकुलेटर फॉर डिवीजन एंड गेट द आंसर. ओके टिल दैट टेक केयर.